and expose this deception of a generation. Today's interview includes materials taken and now offered in three cassette messages. The cassettes include Spiritual Warfare in Your Child and Deception of a Generation, both by Phil Phillips. The third cassette is titled Dungeons and Dragons by Gary Greenwald.
Yeah, as I said, Gary Greenwald goes hard on Dungeons and Dragons, and these cassettes are up there for you to get. But there's a little bit of info just from the book. Now, I told you guys, this wasn't a read episode. This is Turmoil in the Toy Box. But there's a couple little passages I could not mention. And one is about the Cabbage Patch Kids. And he talks about a knockoff of the Cabbage Patch Kids. He says, another doll series similar to Cabbage Patch Kids was introduced at the Toy Fair in New York. This series, Rice Paddy Babies, is based on the refugee theme. The dolls, which are created with an oriental appearance.
No, wait. Oh, you can't be serious. This is terrible. No, stop right there. Are you serious? This is real?
Come with a facsimile of a passport. These dolls received positive reaction from buyers at the toy fair. And he goes on a little bit to talk about how obsessive people with Cabbage Patch Kids were. He says, Cabbage Patch owners, they view it as real. They marry them, bury them, and send them off to summer camp. Some even pay to have braces put on the dolls to correct overbites and other dental problems. This is not reality. Joyce Panicia, a Associated Press writer, sent her Cabbage Patch doll, Alien Julien, to a two-week prep school and then wrote a news story about it, for which they then transmitted to all participating newspapers. Venezia paid $29.95 for the two-week course at Patch Prep. The school was begun by Shirley Dimitri, a Brantford, Connecticut housewife, for the doll who has everything. After 2 weeks of being away at school, the doll returns wearing a school t-shirt, sporting the Patch Prep logo, and carrying a picture of her classmates and a gold-fleckled diploma certifying her skill in computers. Jude, is this where you got your degree at Patch Prep?
Yep. I have a certified skill in computers.
And look at those freckles. He's got them all over his face, just where they're supposed to be.
It's just so weird. This guy's book is just filled with these weird gems. And here's a little bit, a little tiny bit about Star Wars and something else. He says, and when he's talking about Star Wars fans, he says, many are afraid teenagers will develop false notions about religion or adopt false doctrine as a result of the Star Wars influence. Oh, maybe not. This is the most random thing he says. He says, he's trying to talk about people seeing things on the screen and living them. He says, when Burt Reynolds is drunk on beer in Hooper and racing cops in his rocket car, that reinforces the recklessness of the kids who've been drawn to the movie in the first place and are probably sitting in the theater drinking beer. So he's going hard against Burt Reynolds and Hooper, a movie I completely forgot existed. He goes off about Gremlins. He said the rules that Gremlin owners must follow are also laden with occult images. These are rules written on every box containing a Gremlin. We know the Gremlin rules. I'm not reading those. He goes off on Lucasfilm again, and I guess this was pre these movies coming out. He says, Lucasfilm Limited will be premiering two new movies, Labyrinth and Howard the Duck. Both of these releases will be accompanied by a major rollout of children's and juvenile products. Labyrinth will be highly visible in the toy stores. The film stars 80 different Henson-designed puppet creatures, many of which are demonic-looking. As in the past, it is highly likely that the toys will be made in the likeness of these puppet creatures. Rock idol David Bowie will be starring in Labyrinth, as well as writing and performing lots of the music. In one promotional poster, Bowie is seen looking into a crystal ball, which is used in necromancy, communication with the dead. In addition, the new Care Bears movie 2, A New Generation, will most likely spawn new toys. It was in the first Care Bears movie that Care Bear cousins were introduced.
Aww.
Yeah.
Now I want to say this. If you can find a Labyrinth toy, let me know. I've never heard of a Labyrinth toy existing, nor a Howard the Duck. Both of these movies kind of did not do great.
No, there's a reason why that didn't happen.
Yeah, and like I said, there's a lot of nuggets in this book. This is the last one I'll read, and it says, the following 12 forbidden practices should be carefully studied by parents, grandparents, and those concerned with the protection and growth of children. After studying them, watch the cartoons your children are watching. You will be appalled at what you see. You will be moved to seek the Lord on behalf of your little ones. Do you guys want to hear the 12 forbidden practices?
Absolutely.
Yes.
Okay, number one, enchantments or enchanter, and it's just the act of influencing charms and incantations, the practice of magical arts. Two, witchcraft, the practice of dealing with evil spirits, the use of sorcery or magic. That's the same thing. All right, three, sorcery. The use of power gained from the assistance or control of evil spirits, especially for divining. Fucking same thing. All right. Divination, fortune telling, kind of different. Five, Five, wizardry, the art or practices of a wizard. All right, enchantments, witchcraft, sorcery, wizard, that's all the same. Six is a little different. Necromancy, communication with the dead, we know that. Seven, charm, put a spell upon someone to affect by magic. That's, again, it's the same thing. They're all...
No, okay, right. That one's not the same thing, but fine. It's close.
Eight, stargazing, astrology, the divination of the supposed influence of the stars upon human affairs and terrestrial events by their positions and effects. Okay, we know that.
Nine, nerds. Yeah.
Soothsaying, that's the same thing too, the act of foretelling events.
Yeah.
Ten, prognostication, to foretell from signs or symptoms. Okay.
Yeah, that's the same shit, yeah.
11.
You're right. A lot of it is the same shit.
Yeah. 11, observing times. What? Astrology. Again, the same shit. And
it's
number
all
12.
The same shit. Oh, there's more?
You won't. This observing is number 12. The time. Final one. Magic. Witchcraft. Okay.
Okay.
You could have made a list of three things and we would have been fine. We got it. We got it, both you guys. And, you know, oh, God. Before we give our final thoughts, here is a goodbye message from the guy who sent us through all this crap tonight. Here is a goodbye message from Gary Greenwald.
Things are occultic. They're accursed. They teach the children to get into spells and to witchcraft and to serve demon powers. And demon occultic pagan religions are the mystic religions of the East are all propagated through this. And I pray in the name of Jesus today that any of you that have this bondage in your household, your children are rebellious and being drawn by these things. I pray in Jesus' name that God would break that bondage today. We loose it right now and we put the blood of Jesus over you, your family, and your children. God bless you now from the eagle's nest.
Yes, God bless you from Hitler's house. Thank you very much. But I was going to say, before we go, all right, you know what's coming. Brendan Shea, do you have any final thoughts on Phil Phillips and Gary Greenwald?
Yeah, this guy's an asshole, and I've never, ever trusted somebody with two first names.
Yeah, and it was weird to hear you reference in a story on here. What about you, Jude? What do you think about all this?
Everything seems like the up and up. These guys are on top of it. Yep.
Jude's going to be raising his future children right. What about you, Drea?
Yeah, I feel it in my skull, but everything in my bones tell me to just break the curse.
That's a good one, man. I was hoping someone would mention that. Yes. Ready? Let's just get these guys out of our system. Let's all say it together.
One, two, three.
I break the curse.
Break the curse.
Break the curse.
Break the curse.
And I don't want to ignore you like I usually do. What do you think about all this, Rob?
I mean, I'll let this guy sum it up for me.
Well, this is Squidhead. He's from Star Wars. And
Amen, Rob. Amen.
And I teased it a little earlier. There's a reason there are so many sound clips tonight, because my final thoughts will be heard now. And let's hear them.
Stonehenge and
and said, Mommy, God isn't master of the universe. He-Man is. He-Man has more power than Jesus. He-Man has more power than Jesus.
Skeletor, the master of the universe.
I can hardly believe what I'm seeing here. Now, we're looking at occultic things. We're seeing things like the chest of demons and witches and Stonehenge and occultic spell 13. I mean, we're talking about satanic things here. Now, Phil, it's becoming obvious to me what's going on, and I wonder...
What is this that stands before?
Well, this is Squidhead. He's from Star Wars. Well, this is Squidhead. He's from Star Wars.
Starseed is all powerful.
Turn around quick and start to run.
In that aspect, Ken or Phil, what is it about Ken and Barbie here?
Find out I'm the chosen one.
Obi, 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 Obi.
Oh.
Satan is Lord.
And then he summons forth his sword. He-Man is more powerful than Jesus Christ.
Right. Satan is Lord.
Skeletor, the master of the universe.
Well, this is Squidhead. He's from Star Wars.
He-Man has more power than Jesus. He-Man has more power than Jesus. Starseed is all powerful and said, Mommy, God isn't master of the universe. He-Man is.
All right. And now, man, let's talk to an unbeliever. Let's hit the beep, bop, boop. Let's hit the international line. Let's get an unbeliever on the line tonight. A little dialing music. Overseas 6 or longer. Yes, hello. Is someone here?
It's me, K-Mill.
Oh!
Hey!
Oh, K-Mill, welcome.
We called London.
Yeah, we did. Hey, yeah, I was about to say, just a little bit, it's 7 o'clock my time. Man, what time is it in London right now?
It's 1 a.m.
Holy shit. See, that's a poll result superstar, man. He's going to come on at 1 in the morning just to be
partying.
On.
Yeah, I've actually just been drinking alcohol to stay awake, so it's okay.
Oh, perfect. No,
perfect.
I like your style.
Prerequisite.
I like your style.
I do already too. Well, it's good to have you. So yeah, K Mill, man, you have won what? You've won twice in poll results, haven't you?
That's right, yeah.
Man, all right. Well, we are happy to have you on tonight, and we are happy to bring back the original game. It's not even ours. It's one of the other many things we've stolen. Borrowed
directly from Brian.
Look, we're a sequel, okay? All right.
Sorry.
So it goes. But I got to say, before I start the spiel, K-Mill. And yeah, why do they call you K-Mill? Is there a backstory to that?
Yeah, me and my wife met around about the time that Britney Spears married Kevin Federline and his nickname was K-Fed. So she started calling me K-Mill because my real name is Keith Miller.
Oh, and then, of course, naturally, you call her by her first name response.
I call her my lady. It's one of the rules of society.
As Miss Spears was frequently referred to. That's great. I love that story.
That is awesome, man. And it makes me thankful that my first name doesn't start with K, so I wouldn't be K Ryan or something like that. All right. But
could be.
I gotta ask you this question. Are you ready to play everyone's favorite unbelievable podcast, Unbelievers podcast related paranormal game show? Why do I know this?
Let's do this.
All right, hit it. All right, welcome to Why Do I Know This? I am going to ask you 10 multiple choice questions. You have 2 minutes to answer these. Man, I haven't done this in a while. I've kind of forgetting the rules. You have a 2 minute timer to answer them. You can blurt out the answer before I am finished reading them, and you can also choose to skip. But this is the Unbelievers podcast, so we have our own wrinkle in the game, and you get to choose a lifeline between one of the hosts. So between Rob Oakey and Drea Mora, who do you choose, K-Mill, as your lifeline?
I'll stick with the dudes. I'll go with Rob.
Sticking with
the
dudes.
That's a good choice. That's a good choice.
Rob, always the Unbeliever's choice. It's baffling.